everybody, welcome back to Law 1U. My name is Eric, and this is Smite, with random matches in the arena. And this is the new arena. This is the one that just came out June 16th, I believe is when it came out. And as you'll notice, it's daytime, whole new map, but the textures are new, the lighting's new, but the layout's still the same old arena. You still got the camps and all that stuff. The camps are a little bit different, and there goes the first death for Alquan. Alright, so Smite, matches, video recordings. This match, what I've been doing lately, actually, I'll explain first. What I've been doing lately is I've been recording my random matches with my microphone off and just having some videos stockpiled for kind of post-commentary stuff like this. I'm not just trying to put up any video that I come across, but if like I have a particularly good like moment or play, or if I see something that I think is noteworthy or anything like that, then I'm going to go ahead and try and put it up and put some commentary over. And do a quick check on the tickets. We are up by 2 tickets, 1 kill to 1 kill. I got the first kill, and JeBlanc got their first kill. But he got first blood, so he's doing a little bit better. Yes, I've been playing a lot of random matches in all sorts of map modes. Not usually Conquest, just because it feels like it's a little bit too slow and it could take too long and it's just not something that interests me. I do like Conquest, I just don't do that often. And, oh my god, Agni got a kill. Okay. And then Nox died. Okay. This match is the most undeserving, unforgivable matches I have ever played. This match does not have great plays. This match does not have something that will inspire you or make you want to be a better player or even play this game. This match will make you question everything there is about Smite and justice and everything like that. So, I'm guessing from the ELO standpoint, I guess, you know, like, the Smite rankings system, I think I'm supposed to be top ranked in this match for my team, just based off kind of where the portraits are. I believe it goes top to bottom as far as rankings go, which would make a whole lot of sense based on the performance of both Agni and Alquan in this match. And even Huyi, who's our hunter shooting the bow, does not do that good. So, it's kind of a slow start, just kind of skirmishes here and there, no real big team fights yet. And you'll notice, if you look at the enemy team roster, that there is a disconnect. And if you you want to go back to the start of the video, you'll notice that disconnect's been there the entire time. This has been a 4v5 the entire time. And I go down, and you'll notice my backline dashed the fuck away as soon as they could. I think both Agni and Huyi were gone. Or at least Agni and Alquan. I think, yeah. And then Nox stuck around, and I don't know if she died. Yeah, I think she died. So we are down 2 kills to 6 kills in a 4v5. It does not get any better from this point forward. It only gets worse. And this is just the thing where, if this wasn't a 4v5, I wouldn't think fucking twice about this match. But it is. Oh, Alquan misses his ult. He doesn't even try to ult. Yeah, he's still got his ready. For some fucking reason, and he goes in at half health, and gets fucking wrecked by Balloon. Use a fucking ability, Alquan. Oh my god. And I don't know if it's the 4v5 that's just, like, to our disadvantage this match. Like, if it could be to our disadvantage. Because it's so weird. But there are 2 people on my team to pay particular attention to. It's going to be Agni, who, if you're not familiar with the game, is the fire mage with 2 heads. And Alquan, who is the dragon, the water dragon, daily mage. Agni's with me right now. That's him. He dashes ahead. ults on to nothing with his meteor, and nothing happens. I think he did manage to stun Bologna for all the fucking good that did. And Bologna was, of course, the warrior we were chasing. So, oh, I should also mention, this is the first day of the Nox rework, so what you're seeing is all the new Nox animations and all that stuff. And oh god, Agni, please don't die. No, he dead. Yeah, he dead. Tried to save him, but I mean, this is a Diamond Bologna we're up against. And I'm not a Diamond Guan Yu. In fact, I don't play Guan Yu all that often. I'm trying to get better with him. So Bologna pretty much just gets to have her way with us most of the match. Oh, did we get a kill? Okay, we got a kill. We're still winning on tickets, somehow, despite the fact that this is now a 5-9 kill difference in a 4v5 arena. Oh my god. I can't even really explain it. Alquan gets a kill. He does manage. Alquan, for as much shit as I want to give him, he does have a decent mid game. Yeah. I stopped fucking around with the creep and I started going with my team, but by the time that happens, the skirmish is already over and we got a kill. Huyi goes up ahead. Oh no, he doesn't. He just ults. But then they all stick around. Bologna just has us for breakfast. And I do what I can to try and help. And no. So yeah, I guess I got taken apart by Nox right there. Her kit's good. And I wasn't used to it at this point, so I wasn't sure how to dodge it. And really, a good way to get around it is beads or magi, because that'll dodge the silence. It's, you know, it's annoying, but in this match, especially in arena, with as much CC as there is, if you're a melee, you should almost always have... Oh my god, Huyi. I'm pretty sure I saw Huyi dash ahead there instead of just shooting the fucking tower. And he died. And I'm trying. Yeah. There's nothing I can do to. I can slow Bologna down. Somewhat. Yeah. And it cost me, and then no one did anything about the tower. I have no idea where the hell Agni was even coming from. He just jumping around, having the time of his life. You know, good for him. Good for him. So, no one has actives except for Huyi. And he's got beads. And he uses his jump. Motherfucker. But he never uses it at the right moment. Like, this is when you should have used your jump, man. You shouldn't... Of course, I whiffed my ult. So, you know, who am I to talk, but... Fuck it, I know how to use hunters. I know how to use escapes. You don't use your dash to engage. You use it to escape. Because you're a weak little baby. You don't want to be near them. Oh, Kwong goes over there. And I just kind of let him. Not really interested. Figured if he's going to dive on a mage, he should be able to box him down himself. Especially when there's no one else around. Like, if he can't even do that, like... At best, I'm going to go up there and get killed myself. And then he'll die too, because he'll be relying on me. There goes Agni. As at one time, I think Agni actually used his escape, or his dash, to escape. And Zablanca's going real hard for me. I love that about the Guan Yu's one, is just using his heal to just get out right outside of someone's killable range. And just, like, make them switch targets or panic or whatever. It's just, it's really good. And at this point, I get the shield of the Underworld, because Zablanca's just tearing right through me, and Nox is tearing right through me. So I figure, we get into a team fight, you know, I'll take hits, I'll take less damage, and I'll at least damage the enemy team back. It's... I think Shield of the Underworld's a very good, cheap active for this mode. Because you'll take less... like, especially if you're being focused. And there goes Agni dashing forward. Bologna's gonna destroy Ao Kuang, maybe? No. But I'm gonna die. Oh my god. I didn't. I'm gonna say that Shield of the Underworld saved me on that one. Yeah, right. Alright, so if you notice at this point, it is 185 to 210 on the tickets. We're still down 5 kills. Or down 4 kills. But it's a 4v5. This whole time, it's a 4v5. Alright, we're down 3 kills. We're down 2 kills. And I think this is the closest we ever get to evening the score, at least on the kill count. After this point, everyone just fucking does whatever. There goes Agni, dashing in there, and I try to eat the abilities and body block, but he, oh my god, he has no interest in doing fucking anything other than getting himself killed. And Ao Kuang, of course, doesn't bother to use his execute move. Just let us waste time shooting an enemy that doesn't need to be alive. That's always good. And right there, that was a misplay by me. This is still pretty early in the Smite gaming for me for this day. And I wasn't really sure how Nox's new kit works. It's pretty good. I wouldn't say it's overpowered. It just takes some getting used to. I can see it being overpowered in Conquest or something, especially with an Athena, because like you can just, you know, take two people from one lane and suddenly you have a 3-on-1 or a 4v2, and like it would just be really good in that instance. But in pretty much all the other modes, it's not really breaking. I do love the switch they gave Alpwash. With his ult now ends with him, which is, I think, really good. And the notes say it changes how people fight Alpwash. Like, it really fucking does. There goes Agni again. Couldn't get away. Pretty sure he couldn't be bothered by beads. Nox is almost dead. And we managed to punish LeBlanc. Pretty sure he did not want to use his 3 to get stuck. And had he would have gotten killed. Oh, and we get... okay, yes. They got a tower in on us, but we got a tower in on them. And that managed to put the tickets back to about what they were. I popped my shield there. I'm just trying to push them back. I understand there's... okay, I guess Huyi's with me. But I was figuring there was no one else around. And look at the map. Ao Kuang's gone. And now Huyi's gone. But Ao Kuang was in base. And... there goes Agni. Diving into the middle. Fucking round. And I tried to save him. Got killed for it. And I go for the Runeforge Hammer at this point. Because I still figure Zulong's the biggest threat. And I try to get my Wing Blade up too. Because I don't really think that there's any slows. But Wing Blade's second tier is pretty good too. And it's got most of what I want from Wing Blade, so I figure even if I just take it to 2, like, that's good enough. Alright. We're down 20 tickets at this point. 23 kills to 29. Okay, we're within 5 again. Oh my god, Huyi. Every time I see that, it's like, just fucking land a shot, man. It's your job. That's all you gotta do. Oh my god. I'm pretty sure Agni thought he was an assassin. Which is unfortunate for him, because he's definitely not. Huyi using the jump right there. Okay, this is me trying to take advantage of Nox's new kit. And I'm pretty sure... Well, we got a kill for it, but... She got killed, too. So, I would call that not worth it. And then I get killed, too, because my enemy... My team... couldn't fucking be bothered to fight. Apparently. And we're now down by 35. Oh my god. And they have a tower. And I'm praying at this point that my team actually does fight the tower. And, ooh, it's still alive. Fucking kill it, guys. Okay. I think, it's been destroyed. And the tickets are relatively the same. All we gotta do is get some kills. All we gotta do is get this another kill. Come on. Okay. It's close. It's so close. All we have to do is get two kills and not have two deaths. That's all we gotta do. Ao Kuang's gone. He actually gets the kill. All we have to do is get one kill and no Agni dashes forward in front of their base and dies like a bitch. Like the dumbest motherfucker on the face of the earth. All they have to do now is kill two of our creep, and then they've just won a 4v5 arena. And at this point, I am just like shitting myself. And I'm just like, I can't even, I'm not even going to try to surrender vote. They've earned this. They've absolutely earned this. And there's, and see, they, see, that's genius. They go back into their base because all they have to do is kill one of the big creeps at the end. That's all they have to do to win this match. We have to kill two or get one kill on them before they get one creep kill. Here comes our wave. There's their wave. We're not going to get a second chance. They go in. They go for it. And we get a kill. We managed to just barely get a fucking kill. And it's over. And it is the most undeserving win I have ever had. And it could not feel more like a loss. Here's the best part, though. Wait for it. Yeah. Agni's shit talking. And I'm just beside myself, like, are you serious? It's a 4v5. It's a 4v5 with those stats. And Agni shit talking. Like he did anything important. Oh my god. It's so disgusting. And so undeserving. But that'll do it for this video. If you enjoyed what you saw, consider subscribing and stick around for more. Otherwise, I will see you next time. Goodbye.